You're pretty familiar with this place.
Yep, it's the Alchemy Commission. No wonder we were getting those military broadcasts on the way over. Something about the Cloud Knights gathering here, right? It's been such a long journey, but now we're finally gonna meet some Cloud Knights. I'll be back. I didn't lie to you, right? I told you I'd bring you somewhere safe, and I did. Though...
Before I arrived in Starskiff Haven, I had a diviner read my fortune for the journey ahead. He told me not to be concerned with the destination.
Meaning?
Meaning, thank you, miss.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna go report to the nearest captain. You guys can hang around here, but don't run off too far. There'll be Cloud Knights coming to escort you back soon. Bye for now.
The messages never get sent. I wonder what's happening with those three. The Cloud Knights seem to be gathering for the Stellaron disaster. I've delayed for too long. I need more information. Sorry, I have to catch up to my friends. Thank you for looking out for me on this journey. Both of you.
What a huge cauldron.
This Orient cauldron is driven by the cloud hymn magic of our people, the Vidyadara. It drinks the water of the ancient sea like a whale swallows the tide and refines it into medicinal pellets. That the Vidyadara helped to construct contain Cloud Hymn magic. You should take this chance to learn more, young master.
Uh-huh. But I don't need any sort of device to help me command water. What more is there to learn?
You are indeed the chosen one, with endless potential. Yet, Cloud Hymn magic is just the beginning.
Of Vidyadara Mirajako? Have these shadows of the past yet to disperse? These memories... No. They have nothing to do with me anymore.
They say that you are one's power incarnate. Is that true?
Long. I was exiled from the Xianzhou.
I doubt I will be here to see you take charge. No need to feel aggrieved. Vidyadara go through cycles of life and death, existing forever in this world. By the time you are the High Elder, my hatch...
You! You've returned, High Elder! Something terrible is happening in Steel Gorge Waterscape. Please, don't go any further.
I'm sorry. I cannot linger here. My friends have left. I must find them.
You didn't heed us then, and won't heed us now. As headstrong as you always were. It seems you already made your decision. There is a vessel bound for Scale Gorge Waterscape located ahead.
He's here.
Right on time.
That feeling, Kafka, it's welling up within me. That feeling, it's...
Well, don't resist. Let the Mara strike you.
You're here.
It's time to pay the price! You think changing form will help you escape?
I've told you and that woman many times. I am Dan Hung. I've nothing to do with your past.
Dan Hung. You think another name and face can blot out the sin of your past? You didn't even experience death. I will force this suffering upon you, Dan Hung. You will know the pain of death.
Not on my watch. You're not murdering anyone today, fugitive. You're coming with me.
Jingyuan's lapdog. Did the general not teach you to choose your battles wisely?
Hey, move back! Things are about to... Huh? You look so... familiar.
Look out!
Quit hiding. Your true self revealed.
Stop! You.
I have news for you, boy. Behind you is none other. Than the traitor of the Xianzhou. A criminal forever banished. The High Elder of the Vidyadara. Imbibitor Lune. Thought the Stellaron hunters were the only ones to infiltrate the Xianzhou.
In that case, I'll bring both of you to justice. I've heard of you, Imbibitor Lune. First it was the Stellaron hunters, now an exiled criminal has infiltrated the Xianzhou. Sword, heed me!
I have no interest in stoking conflict. I came to ensure the safety of my friends.
Save your excuses for the Shackling Prison!
Out of the way! Do not be afraid.
Better, but I'm afraid you won't be seeing your friends. They're caught in their own bitter struggle.
You're not getting away either!
Is that so? Let's heat things up then, Kafka.
Lady, listen to me. Unleash the Mara.
So it begins.
Anyone. But there's no other way. Forgive me.
I failed. This isn't over.
All of you listen to me. Stop.
Well, Blady? Are you satisfied?
What did you do?
I'm just clearing the stage for the grand entrance. Can't have you three misbehaving in front of the LaFu's hotshot general.
Qingyuan.
General!
Many years have passed since the two of you departed the Xianzhou, and yet the circumstances of your return appear to be equally unhappy. If you still thought of me as a friend, you should have forewarned me.
My task is complete.
That it is. Thank you for assisting the Xianzhou in this small matter. Take this person away. I will pretend I didn't see anything this time.
General, I...
Now is not the time.
It has been a long time, old friend. I'm sorry. You cannot leave yet. Your Astral Express friends are waiting for you in Scale Gorge Waterscape. Shall we go and see them together? Lunarescent Depths, a realm of singular beauty. Scale Gorge Waterscape is the same as when I last laid eyes on it. And here we stand so different from one another. The flesh of long-life species may be immortal, but the constant of heaven and earth eludes them.
You know the Vidyadara hatching rebirth cycle, General. The waters of the ancient sea have cleansed Dan Feng of his past sin. The person that once stood here alongside you is no more. I am Dan Hung. Whether Dan Feng was hero or villain has nothing to do with me. I bore his punishment, accepted my eternal banishment without complaint. But do not let his shadow cloud your estimation of me, General.
Raising old nets only darkens the water, an exercise in unhappiness. Perhaps it is your visage, the horns on your head, or the unmistakable air of the High Elder that makes the separation nigh impossible for me.
I already told you,
You did. But to what effect? If words alone were enough to change the heart, this world would be without quarrel. If you wish to rid me of the illusion of Dan Feng, you must do something for me. Before I can let Dan Feng die and revoke your banishment edict, I need him to do me one final favor. I can guarantee you that when it is done, you will no longer walk in anyone's shadow aboard the Lo Fu.
I may not be capable of the things that Dan Feng was capable of.
You must do it, or my promise will count for naught. If you wish to blame someone, blame your previous incarnation. Had he not committed that terrible sin, had the power of dragon transmutation been passed on intact, I would have no need to compel you. It is as I said. Here we stand so different from one another. Dan Feng is no more. Now, there is only Dan Hung. But I am the general of the Lo Fu. There are things that I wish I did not have to do, and yet I must. Let us talk of happier tidings. The friends you made on the Express are here. Do you wish to see them?
You brought them here?
Yes. They are waiting in the Dragon Vista Rain Hall. Go. Your friends are waiting for you. I have been keeping careful watch against the abominations of abundance, the Stellaron Hunters, and the Disciples of Sanctus Medicus. The hunt is far from over, yet all the while we find ourselves at war with other evil spirits. From this battle onward, the Alliance must fight the Legion to our dying breath, even if it means the end of the Lo Fu. Our intelligence tells us that the Legion are a mad and destructive war machine. Yet they never took up arms against the Alliance. The armies of the Seven Ravagers all have their own means of destruction. They are not to be taken lightly. Lord Ravager Fantalia favors internal collapse, which is why she masterminded the Stellaron Crisis and urged the Disciples of Sanctus Medicus out of the shadows. Now that Do you know something? When Dan Feng committed his great crime, the Ten Lords Commission advocated strongly for him to be destroyed. The Vidyadra, on the other hand, were split evenly in their favor and disfavor of the motion. The dragon transmutation inheritance was not intact after all. The senior Vidyadra hated you, yet did not dare to kill you. The Vidyadra were under great pressure. In order to placate the Ten Lords and Skyfaring Commissions, They performed an exuviation charm on Don Fong against his will. Look, your friends are taking the fight to the Legion as we speak.
We need to help them. Let's go! I sense a storm. The heavens surge. Celestial dragon. Quick!
This is our chance.
Ha! Conflict is pitiless!
Tough luck running into me!
Valkyries. Heaven surge. Quick!
This is our chance.
There's no time to lose. Here is thunder!
Told you I could fight! You! You can't run!
The strength.
A foregone conclusion.
Time for the master.
Show no mercy.
Heaven surge. Cloud fairy dragon. Rise.
Let's go.
Follow my charge.
Rules are made to be broken.
Conflict is pitiless!
You have the worst luck running into me! Stay right there while I give you a present!
Is that it?
You can't run! Gotta try hard sometimes! Check out this awesome move!
Surge. Celestial dragon. Quick!
This is our chance.
Batter up!
Here is thunder!
With me out here, how can we lose?
Heaven surge. Cloud fairy dragon. Rise!
Let's make it quick.
There's no time to lose.
My turn. Stay right there while I give you a present.
Just a scratch.
Try that again.
I wish not to use the strength. Heaven surge. Celestial dragon. Quick!
Xingyuan, where have you been?
Forgive my late arrival, Lady Fu. We are indebted to you and your forces. The Seats of Divine Foresight relate the battle reports to me. As for Fantilia's plan...
The Ambrosial Arbor. That's her focus. Lord Ravager Fantilia's strategy was to create civil strife, then let it consume the Xianzhou from within. She wanted to use the Arbor to disseminate the power of the Plague's Author, and turn the Lafu into a hell of undying abominations.
That is clear to me now. Friends of the Astral Express, I have brought someone with me whom I think you'll be eager to see.
Huh? Is that Don Hung? You are Don Hung, right? What's with the horns?
It's a long story, March. It's me.
So, you do have secret strength.
Let us save such reminiscence for later, shall we? My astral guess. When you first appeared on the Lafu, your stated aim was the resolution of the Stellaron crisis. I was concerned that the Stellaron hunters harbored ulterior motives and refused your offer. I see now that I was overly anxious. Nevertheless, it is true that the motives of the Stellaron hunters were not what they appeared. In order that the Express and the Xianzhou fight side by side, Kafka lured you here and broadened the scope of the crisis. In doing so, she succeeded in making it clear that your sincerity is beyond doubt. The Lafu is in your debt, and I have no right to seek further assistance from you. However, as Lady Fu has explained, the appearance of Fantilia means that the situation is far from under our control. As General of the Lafu, it would be foolish of me not to ask Don Hung and the rest of you for your strength at this critical moment.
Even if the crisis on the Lafu had nothing to do with the Stellaron, I would be willing to help. But I can't speak for the other members of my crew. Explore, understand, establish, and connect. As the crew of the Express, that's the Trailblaze creed we follow. Still, when the journey gets tough, those words can feel far off. Fear, risk, enemies, and death are the obstacles we face in pursuit of the creed. That's why the nameless who are able to stay the course number few indeed. Whether our destination lies before us or behind us, the decision is ours to make. Here, as on the Express, every vote counts.
Don Hung?
Thank you, Don Hung.
How am I still one of the nameless? I stand here at the mercy of others without true freedom to speak. But as a descendant of the Vidyadara, I will fulfill my duty to the Lafu.
Great! Everyone's just as heroic as when they arrived. So, what's the master plan, General?
There is no master plan, only a bet. A bet on the senior Vidyadara's incomplete exuviation charm, and on Dong Hong's ability to access the memories of the High Elder.
High Elder?
When the Rainbow Arbiter severed the Ambrosial Arbor, remnants of the curse of the plague's author lingered. In order to make the stemming of those remnants a possibility, the Lafu invoked the power of the Scions of Permanence. Under the direction of the High Elder, the Vidyadara guided the waters of the ancient sea to flood the Scale Gorge waterscape delve and contain the Arbor. To commemorate this magnificent feat and sacrifice, the Alliance erected the Dragon Vista Rain Monument, a Vidyadara statue.
Oh, it looks so much like Don Hung. I wonder if... The statue... Is that... Don Hung's brother?
I see why you might think so. These events occurred a long time ago,
Yet successive generations of High Elders have not differed greatly in their appearance. That is, until the current generation. The most recent successor did not inherit the same level of power, and their appearance is that of a child. Do you understand, Don Hong? Since Dong Feng perished, the Lofu Vidyadara have no longer had an individual capable of performing such feats. But you, who once kept watch over the arbor, should be able to open a way through to that great tree. What happens next is in your hands.
The annals mention that Scale Gorge Waterscape was once the location of Dragon Palace. Small wonder. Look at all these submerged structures.
I was fortunate enough to be here during the Shuhu upheaval period. I witnessed this place in its prime. An age passed. The palace was left in ruins, and the Vidyadara used their sacred homeland to imprison the Arbor. The Lofu and the Xianzhou are greatly indebted to them. Lady Fu.
Here, General.
Remain here. Lead the Cloud Knights in defense of this passage. We must prevent further incidents.
Jingyuan, General, are you planning to face Dantilia alone?
I wouldn't say so. I'll be counting on a few friends for support.
General, don't cast us aside. We're willing to go with you.
Yes, General. We may not be the mightiest force, but it's our duty as Cloud Knights to protect the Xianzhou. How can we let outworlders face the danger while we stay behind the lines? With your permission, sir, allow me to lead the way.
I understand your sentiment, soldiers. But the adversary ahead of us is not an abomination of abundance. They are a Lord Ravager of the Antimatter Legion. Crossing this line will bring you into the conflict between the Rainbow Arbiter and the Ruin Author. You have a more important duty.
Cloud Knights, attention!
After I enter the Ambrosial Arbor, and if the seawater returns to its original state, you must withdraw immediately and seal off the Delve once more. The Master Diviner will lead you.
Yes, General!
Lady Fu, if I am unable to return, I entrust you with the important task of relaying the full account to the other Xianzhou ships.
I trust you will be here to reissue the order in person. But whatever the outcome, I will do as you command and honor the mission.
Spoken like a true general.
Thank you.